Alright, how's everyone doing? Welcome to From Z to A, Alphabetical Interviews with Zach Anderson. I am Zach Anderson. Today we are here at White House Productions in Shelton for the 8th edition of Monsters of Acoustic Rock, and I am joined by Jason Garish. So thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you for inviting me.
You're welcome. So I'm going to ask you the difficult questions, as long as they have something to do with the letters of your name.
Okay.
Alright, so we're going to start with Jay. Tell me about your musical journey. How long have you been playing? Where and when was your first gig?
My first gig was a little over 2 years ago, believe it or not. July 11th was my first gig. I was doing, first official gig, first solo gig. Right. Previous to that, I'd been hosting some open mics.
Okay.
But my first gig was actually a gig that I, the musical performance, and I had some of my artwork on display too.
All right.
Which was at a tea house in Bristol.
Oh, cool.
Which was kind of cool, yeah.
All right.
Kind of a country western theme thing.
Nice. Very cool. How much does the audience affect your set? Do you feed off of them, or do you like continue with whatever set list you started with?
It varies by audience, which I guess they do affect it very much, because if I feel something's going to, if they're wanting to hear more ballads, I'll go that direction, or if they're wanting to hear more upbeat stuff, I've been known to throw set lists completely out
right,
there,
right.
Right halfway into a set, so...
Your songwriting process, how do you go about it? Do you start with lyrics or music? Does it vary song to song?
It's almost always lyrics first.
Okay.
Because I was a poet before I ever wrote music.
Mm-hmm.
So, lyrics, or I can't think of a single song I've started music first, actually. So,
all right.
So yeah.
Nice. Now, tell me about one occasion where a show didn't go quite as planned, whether it was for the better or for the worse.
Thankfully I haven't had too many train wrecks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, and my career is still young, so,
right.
So I haven't had too many of those. I mean, I've had a few where there have been technical glitches,
mm-hmm.
things of that nature, but that's every live show.
Oh, sure.
I mean,
yeah.
You're never gonna, and that's why you go to a live show, is you're there to interact with the audience, and they're to interact with you, so it's not a... If you wanted to hear perfection, you'd stay home and listen to the CD.
Oh, sure, yeah.
You know, so I go to live performances to have that. Maybe there's a flub note, but you know what? It's all good.
Yeah,
so,
exactly. Yep.
So, I've had some that have been long sets, but I've had some good shows. Luckily, knock on wood, I've been pretty lucky that way.
All right.
Fortunate that way.
Nice. So tell me about your new album. You released one recently, correct?
Yep. Yep, released in March. It's Menthol Memories, Whiskey Wishes, and it's kind of it's a culmination of past experiences. You know, some stuff. A lot of it's autobiographical, some of it's not. But it's kind of stuff I wanted to leave in the past, kind of thing. So I was hoping to kind of get that out of the way and move forward, kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it's got a lot of stuff that kind of relates to. To things that happened in my past relationships, past experiences, but you know, it's not necessarily a place where I am right now.
Okay.
You know, so but it's you know, really. I started the first song I wrote for it was Training Wheels.
Mm-hmm.
Let's put it that way, and that was kind of a song I wrote in like 5 minutes. To tell you the truth,
yeah.
It's sometimes the other songs on the CD weren't as easy to write as that one.
Mm-hmm.
But it's one of those fluky things. Sometimes you just, the energy starts flowing and you go with it. It's my sophomore effort, or actually no, freshman, I guess you'd say, right? First year?
Yep.
So it'd be my freshman effort, I guess.
Very cool. Well, I've been listening to it a lot lately and I'm really enjoying it. So.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. What types of guitars do you own, and do you have a go-to guitar for live shows, or does it, depending on the situation?
9 times out of 10, I'm playing with my Breedlove.
Okay.
That's my go-to acoustic, because so far all my shows have been solo acoustic. Either it's been me or me with a fiddle player, or sometimes I'll play with some of my friends, like Jonathan 6-8, people like that, you know, but primarily it's just me. So I'll play with the acoustic, and I love the Breedlove, so I've been playing with that
right.
Almost exclusively. Like the farmer markets where I don't have power, I'll bring my, I have an Epiphone, mm-hmm. an old Epiphone, which is an absolute warhorse.
Right.
The thing is, it's a beast, and it'll go through anything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll play with that out at the farmers markets where I don't have a PA system kind of thing, and that projects.
Right.
It's a full size dreadnought, so it projects really nicely, and I can use that. But my go to weapon right now of choice is the Breedlove. I absolutely love that guitar.
Very pretty.
And thank you. I mean, right now the only electrics I own, aside from I got an Ibanez bass, but I only have two electric guitars right now,
mm-hmm.
and those are both Telecasters.
Yep.
Which you hear on the album, but right now there's, you know, I mean, I used to own a lot of electrics, but I pared it down to kind of, I'm like, I'm playing country, I really don't need, you know, Hornet G3T and all the Deans with the crazy,
mm-hmm.
you know, crazy kind of shreddy guitar stuff.
It
didn't fit my style, and if it's not getting played, I'd rather have somebody play it and use it, you know, than to,
yeah.
sit on my wall.
So I like to end all my interviews with three interesting or random facts about yourself that many people might not know.
All right, three random facts. I probably should have prepared a little bit more of this.
It's the most difficult question.
It is. Random facts. Well, let's go back to previous question. I'm a published poet.
Mm-hmm.
I've had some artwork on display. I've been a programmer in a previous life. I mean, that's a random fact,
yeah.
I guess. So, there's two, right?
Yeah.
What third? Let's see. Random fact. Those are hard ones. let me think. What's a random fact? I don't know.
What's your ideal breakfast?
Ideal breakfast? I mean, I generally just eat cereal in the morning.
Mm.
I try to keep away from probably Honey Nut Cheerios, probably my go-to.
That's
cheap and it's good on the heart. So
there you go.
but yeah, I mean, ideally I'd like to have bacon and eggs every morning.
Oh, sure,
but unfortunately, heart disease runs in the family. So I'm not, you know, heck, I'd love to have biscuits and gravy every morning.
There you go.
But no, we're doing the cereal. We're being good.
Being
okay. You know, doing the healthy things. So
Well, thank you so much for being on the show. And we're going to cut to a performance from you in a second.
Awesome.
If you'd like to check out Jason Garish, please visit the link below. And now we'll cut to a performance from Jason. So thanks again, and we'll see you next time.
Defenses.
hide your darkness with a kiss. Is the key to your own self. Cool the flames of your own hell. We've all made a mistake. Keep your demons company.